Okay, let's go.
We are talking about remote roles, remote jobs in cybersecurity. Many of us haven't even seen an office in years, and a lot of us like it. I think that you can get remote cybersecurity roles. I'm not trying to go back. I am happy from home, working and being successful. And listen, I'm not trying to go back. I'm sure you aren't either. Are you? Hi, and welcome back to the Struggle Security YouTube channel, where we are normalizing struggling in cybersecurity. If this is your first time here, or if you've come here before, I want you to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you can get more and more of this type of content. Let's jump right into the subject where we are talking about remote roles, remote jobs in cybersecurity. One thing that a lot of us cybersecurity professionals have seen is that as a result of the pandemic, we have jumped into a remote or working from home type of structure. Many of us haven't even seen an office in years. We haven't touched an office. We haven't flown a flight. We haven't went at all into a customer environment in years. And a lot of us like it. And a lot of us want to stay that way. So that's what this video is for. We're going to look at what it looks like and how to find some of these remote cybersecurity roles.
Okay, let's go.
I want you to try to understand is what cybersecurity jobs or what cybersecurity responsibilities can you do remotely? So the first one we want to start off in looking at is the SOC or security admin type of role and some of those responsibilities. Jumping right into it is that one thing that a lot of these SOC admins or security admins do is that they log into customer environments and they service, configure, and harden systems. These are things that you can do right from your home. You can utilize a VPN or virtual private network, jump into a customer environment, and be able to service their environment.
Yeah, boy.
Another thing that you can do is monitor and investigate SIM or security information and event management system dashboards for suspicious activities. That's one thing that happens a lot of times is that many laptops and workstations and servers, they have different agents or different software running on them that is monitoring the security related logs and events happening on those devices. And one thing that somebody can do from home who's working in a SOC or security admin type of role is that they can look at these dashboards from their computers, from the comfort of their own home, and be able to understand, hey, does this look weird? Does this look malicious? And typically this comes in the form of tickets. They have a ticketing system where you can respond to these and be able to tell individuals and tell companies, hey, this looks funny, this looks suspicious, let me elevate this to the next level. Another one is communicating security-related information to supervisors or managers or executive-level individuals. This might come in the form of sending emails, which can be done from home. It might also come in the form of writing more formal type of reports. You can use Microsoft Word, you can use WordPad, you can use emails, and you can write these things out and write these reports to communicate security-related information about organizations and situations and activities that's been happening in customer environments. Another role that you might be in is that of a cybersecurity consultant, right? A cybersecurity consultant many times can do a lot of things straight from home. Responsibilities such as setting up and leading out in workshops and meetings with customers to address a lot of the cybersecurity concerns. So this might be setting up a Teams call or a Zoom call or a WebEx call. You can do brainstorming sessions, strategy sessions. You can go through documentation. You can do all of this stuff. Another one is you can conduct even things like red teaming or pen testing type of activities. I've done plenty of these as it concerns remote pen tests, where pretty much the customer would give me VPN access or some type of access into their environment and say, hey, find the vulnerabilities in our systems because we're gonna allow you in it from a virtual type of connection. And many times this is the way the bad guys get in. They might send a phishing email and after someone clicks on that email, they gain direct access into the customer environment. This is something that you can emulate in a red team or pen testing type of service. So cybersecurity consultants can do this also from home. Another one, and you might not have to have thought this, is that you can perform incident response activities and malware reverse engineering services from home. Many times what happens is that in an incident response, when somebody is responding or organization is responding, we collect information, collect data, forensic images to do analysis offline. You don't have to be on site. You don't have to be in that customer environment. You don't even have to be in an office in order to do malware reverse engineering or some type of offline forensics or investigation activities. So these are some things that you can do from home. I'm gonna show you here on LinkedIn. I wanted to do a search where we can look to try to find some of these remote cybersecurity roles. So this is my LinkedIn here. One thing that I wanna do is that put in security analyst. And you see here where it gives some options here. Right here within the LinkedIn system or the LinkedIn platform, you can choose remote. And as you see for the security operation or security analyst type of role, it says shows over 10,000 results. Let's take a look at this, right? So these are some of the results that come up. Very much so, this is tailored to my profile and to my background, but you can put it in for yourself and look for some of what these roles look like. And in every case, you see remote, 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 remote. So let's just pull up one of these for Zendesk. This is an organization, the software development. And this is something that you can apply to. So this would work on LinkedIn. This can work on Indeed, many different types of platforms where you can search directly for remote roles by putting in the role specifically on LinkedIn and putting in remote. Another piece of advice that I want to give is that even after you apply to these roles, when recruiters reach out to you, I want you to reaffirm or re-ask the question about if this role is remote. Sometimes recruiters and organizations maybe put out that remote bait and they're looking to try to reel you in, but not really have a fully or very much so remote type of role. So you can ask the recruiters, and if they reach out to you, say, hey, I saw that this role was advertised as a fully remote role. Is it indeed a fully remote role, or does it have a different structure as it concerns remote work? Wait for the answer. And then you can tell them, hey, if they say that this is not a fully remote role, that it's hybrid, or that we are just doing remote for the time being, but after certain things come out of place for the United States or whatever country you're in, we're going back to on-site, you can kindly tell them, hey, I'm not looking for a hybrid or a temporarily remote role. I'm looking for a remote role for 100% of the time. So thank you for your time. Another thing to do, this is the third piece of advice, is that I want you to take a look at the news cycles.
Okay.
Look at these different organizations that you might want to work for and Google them. Google to see what their remote role standards are. And that's something that would really give you a heads up to say, hey, if I apply to this organization, am I going to be able to work in a remote, 100% remote cybersecurity role? And the last one I want to give is that network with people in organizations and ask them what their organization's policy and stance is on fully remote roles. I think that when you hit all of these four pieces, is that one, you research and you apply to these roles, talk to recruiters and let them know that you want fully remote, paying attention to the news cycles, and four, networking with people that work for organizations, I think that you can get remote cybersecurity roles, even as organizations are trying to bring people into the office. Hopefully this has been valuable to you. Let me know in the description section if there are more things that you want me to cover on this subject. Come back again to the Struggle Security YouTube channel, where we are normalizing struggling in cybersecurity.